In this video, we will discuss about the structure of anal canal. Anal canal is the final segment of gastrointestinal tract. It has an important role in defecation and maintaining fecal continence. In this image, you can see the anal canal. It extends below the rectum till the anus, around which we can see internal anus sphincter and the external anus sphincter. About its position. Is located within the anal triangle of perineum between right and left ischioanal fossa. About ischioanal fossa, we will see later in this video. It is about 4 cm in length. The canal begins as the continuation of rectum and passes inferior posteriorly to terminate in the anus. It is a continuation of rectum and terminate in the anus. Is situated within the anal triangle of perineum. In this image, you can see the anal triangle. It is formed by an imaginary line between two ischial tuberosities on right side and left side. Then, the other two wings are formed by sacrotuberous ligament on both sides. So, the inner space is called the anal triangle. In this image, you can see the location of anal canal within the anal triangle. About its anatomical structure. There are two anal sphincters. It is internal anus sphincter and external anus sphincter. The internal anus sphincter surrounds the upper two-thirds of anal canal. It is formed from thickening of involuntary circular smooth muscle. The internal anus sphincter surrounds upper two-thirds and it is formed from involuntary circular smooth muscle. The external anus sphincter is formed by voluntary muscle. It surrounds the lower two-thirds of anal canal. It merges superiorly with the tuborectalis muscle of pelvic floor. At the junction of rectum and the anal canal, there is a muscular ring. We already told rectum anal canal is the continuation of rectum. So, where the rectum joins with the anal canal or continue as joint canal, anal canal, there is a muscular ring and that is called the anorectal ring. It is formed by fusion of 3 muscles, internal anus sphincter, external anus sphincter and tuborectalis muscle. This muscular ring is palpable on digital rectal examination. Except during defecation, the anal canal is collapsed by internal and external anal sphincters and it prevents the passage of fecal material. This is about external anus sphincter, which covers the lower two-thirds, it is formed by voluntary muscle. This is internal anus sphincter, which is formed by involuntary circular smooth muscle. It is around the upper two-thirds of anal canal. This is the anal, from here till here is the anal canal. And this is the anus, which is the opening of anal canal. External anal sphincter, and this is internal anal sphincter, and this is the anal canal. From here till here is the anal opening or anus. Coming to internal structure. Internally, it is lined by same epithelial lining as rectum, which is columnar epithelium. In its superior aspect, the superior part of anal canal is lined by columnar epithelium, same as that of rectum. But its mucosa is organized into longitudinal fold, and that longitudinal folds are called the anal column. These columns are joined together at its inferior end by anal wall. The in between anal wall, there are small pouches and they are called the anal sinuses. Anal sinuses contain glands which secrete mucus. This anal valves of all anal column collectively form an irregular circle and that is called the pectinate line or dentate line. This line divides the anal canal into upper and lower parts. They differ both in structure and neurovascular supply. Inferior to pectinate line, the anal canal is lined by non-keratinized squamous epithelium. Above pectinate line, we can see anal column with the columnar epithelium, and below pectinate line we can see non-keratinized stratified squamous epithelium, and that is called the ANN pectoral. It is pale and smooth. It transitions at the level of inter-sphincteric groove to true skin. This ANN pectoral joins with the true skin at the level of inter-sphincteric groove, and the true skin is lined by other skin of the body, keratinized stratified squamous epithelium. In this image, you can see the internal structure of anal canal. This is the anal column, the longitudinal mucosal fold of rectum or columnar epithelium. The lower end of anal column is joins with the adjacent anal column, and that is called the anal wall. The spaces in above the anal wall or in between the anal column is called the anal sinuses. Anal sinuses has anal glands. The valves of different anal column join together form an irregular muscular ring, and that is called the dentate line or pectine line. This line divides the anal canal into upper and lower part. The lower part is lined by non-keratinizing squamous epithelium. Till a transition portion or where it joins with the true skin of the remaining part of the body, and that is called the anal verge. Below the anal verge, we can see the true skin lined by keratinizing squamous epithelium. This is the external anal sphincter, and this is the internal anal sphincter. About its anatomical relation, anterior, posterior and lateral structures to anal canal. Anterior structures are different in male and female. Posterior and lateral, same structures are seen in both sexes. In male, the anterior structures include perineal body, urogenitus, diaphragm, urethra and bulb of penis. In female, we can see perineal body, urogenital diaphragm and vagina. Posteriorly, in both sexes, ano-coccygeal ligament, coccyx and sacrum. Laterally, we can see ischioanal fossa. This image shows the lateral boundary of anal canal. This is the anal canal. Laterally, on both sides, there is ischiorectal fossa, which is otherwise called ischioanal fossa. In this image, you can see the urogenital diaphragm anteriorly to, this is the anal opening, urogenital diaphragm anterior to anus or anal canal. In this image, you can see the posterior relation, sacrum and coccyx. And the entire anus is surrounded by various muscles like piriform, anal coccygeal raphe, obturator ramus, iliococcygeus. Here you can see the perineal body, which is a fibromuscular ring, arcus tendinus, coccygeus muscle, and above which you can see pubovaginalis, puborectalis, vagina in female and urethra just above the vagina. Next comes neurovascular supply and lymphatics. As we have seen already, the pectinate line divides the anal canal into upper and lower portion. So both of these parts have different arterial, venous, nerve and lymphatic supply. About the arterial supply of upper part or above pectinate line, superior rectal artery and anastomosing branches from middle rectal artery. The arterial supply below the pectinate line, there is inferior rectal artery and anastomosing branches from middle rectal artery, same as above pectinate line. For the venous drainage, it is superior rectal vein which empties into inferior mesenteric vein, which is a part of portal venous system. Below pectinate line, it is inferior rectal vein which empties into internal pudendal vein, which is a part of or which joins with the systemic venous system. So upper part connected to portal venous system and the lower part is connected to systemic venous system. The nerve supply is from inferior hypogastric plexus. It is sensitive to stretch. Here we can see inferior rectal nerves, which are branches of pudendal nerve. They are sensitive to pain, temperature, touch and pressure. Here it is sensitive to stretch. Here it is sensitive to other sensation like pain, temperature, touch and pressure. The lymphatic drainage is also different. Above pectoral line, the lymphatic drainage is into internal iliac lymph nodes. Below pectoral line or in the lower region, the drainage is into superficial inguinal lymph nodes. About a clinical condition called as pathological hemorrhoids. The hemorrhoids are vascular cushion found within the anal canal. It helps in the maintenance of fecal continence. They are normally seen in healthy individuals. So hemorrhoids are vascular cushion in the anal canal, which are normally found in healthy individuals, and it helps in the maintenance of fecal continence. When hemorrhoids become swollen and distended, then they are called a pathological hemorrhoids. This is internal hemorrhoid near to internal anal sphincter. This is external hemorrhoid near to external anal sphincter. This is the swollen and distended hemorrhoid which have come out of anal canal or anal opening. That is the end of structure of anal canal. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe and share.